Iranian aide faces prison sentence for, quote, homosexual propaganda in Iran. Apologies in advance for butchering this name. An indictment has been issued for Shahindokht Molaverdi, the former aide for women's and family affairs in Iran, after she shared a UN poster to mark the International Day of Families, which featured a simple illustration depicting several families, including two same-sex couples with children. She was charged with, quote, propaganda against the regime, encouraging corruption and prostitution, and providing classified information and documents to disrupt national security. Under Article 639 of the Islamic Penal Code, anyone who encourages or incites people to moral corruption or depravity is sentenced to 1 to 10 years in prison. Yeah, so as you can, well, if you're watching this live, you can see on the screen the cartoon that she shared. When I looked at this cartoon, I couldn't even tell who the homosexual couple was at first. I was like, where are the gays? Give me the gays, because I love my people. Yeah, so it's this little couple in the bottom right corner with yellow pants and blue pants. You can't even really tell that they're men, I guess.
And the lower left, there's two dresses holding a baby, too.
See, I didn't even notice the lesbians either.
Yeah, one's got a blue dress and one has like a purplish dress and one's holding a baby.
It's, I mean, it's cute. But yeah, even this very abstract post of this cartoon that she did on the platform Telegraph, that she did in as a mistake, she made statements about how it was a mistake. She's still facing up to 10 years in prison for this. And this is a pro-regime person.
Guilt by association is just absolutely horrible. And she's
So just to be clear, she's pro-regime, and she didn't even know what she's sharing, and she could get 10 years up to 10 years in prison. Okay, sorry, Rivka, go on. You were saying?
I'm saying it's like this awful guilt by association. Even if she did know what she was sharing, and even worse if she didn't, just because it's on there and she happened to share it because she was saying, "Oh, families, yay!" Now all of a sudden she's responsible for everything on there, whether she agrees with everything or not, and therefore she's also guilty. And then I also think that that charge at the end about sharing state secrets, like, I'm not sure what that's about, but to me that almost sounds like something they tacked on the end to make sure that she, you know, they can get her. It's not really the gay thing. It's the fact that she shared state secrets.
Well, it's not state secrets. It's providing classified information and documents to disrupt national security.
Well, yeah.
So
that's
what about this is classified.
That's what I mean. It sounds like they just made that up as like a charge to, you know, say that, you know, this, she's not only did she do this, look what she actually did, something. She shared classified documents.
So she just clicked on share and she could go to 10 years in prison for like this. You have to be very careful in Iran what you do on social media. Like the wrong retweet could get you 10 years in prison. But I mean, can't she just say like there's no way, like she should go and say like, okay, these two people have short hair, but obviously one of them is wearing pink. That's a girl with short hair. Like, I didn't think that they're gay. Like, she should be like, I thought that they were, like, there's no way, like, their genitals are not showing. So how could you know they're gay, right? So, like, that should be her defense. By the way, the tweet that you're looking at, the tweet that is embedded here, this guy is actually calling out for attack. Like, he's like, get her. Like, he's like, well, look at this, you know, monstrosity. Look at, oh, my God, like, what the fuck is happening? Like, he's, like, angry. And he's like, he's asking the government to go after her on a tweet. How come this tweet is still standing? Like, this is, it's fine, I guess, you know, but like if I posted a tweet, for example, saying like, oh my God, look at all this gay shit. This is horrible. This is like disgusting. Twitter will take me down. But yet this guy, it did it in Persian. And he has like, look, he has like almost 2,000 likes. And the tweet is still standing. What the hell? But Shopan, you want to say, you wanted to say something?
Well, to Rivka, I wanted to say, no, those that's not a lesbian couple. Those are just gals being pals.
Gals being pals.
And also, like, the sentence she got, 10 years in prison, that's the same sentence, I think, a few weeks ago, this guy got for murdering his own daughter. So, yeah, sharing a tweet and murdering your own daughter, they pitch you the same sentence in Iran, apparently.
So, I think part of what got her in trouble is the caption that's on the UN post. So, the caption on the UN post says, "The structure of family has changed in the past few decades, but the United Nations still considers it as a main division of society," adding that it is important to support vulnerable families at a time of crisis. So, the original post was acknowledging these as actual families, as partners. So yeah, it makes it a little bit harder to say these are sisters, they're gal pals, they're sharing, look at they, oh, I'm holding my baby, I'm showing my girlfriend, my friend who's a girl, you know.
Are you saying that two sisters can't be a family with one of the, is that what you're saying? No, I'm just kidding. Well, no, it just, I'm just laughing it on some level, because not that I'm making an equivalence, okay, because I'm not. But I'm kind of laughing, like, so if this was somebody who shared a picture that people in the United States thought that there was something in there that they found problematic, you know, and now all of a sudden this person's canceled. You know what I mean? It's kind of, it just made me laugh a little bit.
Okay, yeah, it's not equivalent at all. Yeah, of course.
No, but I'm just, was just thinking about it, you know, in terms of.
All right, but can I read the Persian caption?
Yeah, please caption? Do.
Okay,
please
so do. The Persian caption is saying 15, was it 15 of May?
Yeah, I think it was a while ago that it happened.
Yeah, so this guy.
The charges are new.
The charges are new, but this guy is announcing what, like, this guy in Persian is announcing when was this shared, right? On the hashtag for the day, the International Day for Women, what on this day, Mrs. Molaverdi, the advisor to President Rouhani, so he, posted a picture. That has two examples of homosexual sexuality as a suggestion to for families for a different family structure. So he's saying that she posted this as with two examples of homosexuality as alternative family structures. Then he continues in the second paragraph saying this is an extreme decline in morality. In and the understanding of family values that should be condemned by President Rouhani. That's what the tweet says. Man, that was
your Persian sucks.
Yeah.
That's the only reason why we have you, and this is what
hey. Okay, I'll see myself out. Hey, please. He's using a lot of Arabic, not common words to just show off his Persian and Arabic. So that's why it's hard. Okay, anyways, I don't care.
Can I be a homophobe for a moment? Like,
please.
You like see in the picture, like the two dads and the kid. Like, see the distance between the dads and the distance between them and the kid. Clearly, that's what a homosexual couple does. They distance the kid so much that the kid isn't even
not funny.
Like,
not funny.
They're in a family.
Good try, but not funny. Hold on.
I thought it was funny.
Okay, whatever.
Okay, are we done with this story?
Let me see what the comments on Facebook are. One second. Okay. What a shithole country. Joe is saying Iran sounds like a lovely country to visit and live there. So much love, so much good people. Obviously being satirical. But to be fair, this is like a lot of Iranian people are horrified of this. Like the people themselves are like, look at the shit that we have to deal with kind of attitude, right? So let's be fair to the people there. All right. Anyways, news. Thank you for joining us. Subscribe to our channel. Hit the bell thingy. If you haven't, I don't know why. What's holding you back? Okay. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, why haven't you subscribed to our channel? Explain that to us, please. Like, bell, and also, if you're not getting notifications and stuff because YouTube is not telling people that we have shows, because YouTube is like, oh, this person told us that they want to get your shows, right? They want to get your videos, but nah, we think it's no. And look, oh, they also hit the bell button, but nah, you guys are too controversial. We want to show them mainstream stuff. We want to show them CNN or cat videos or whatever. But even there are people like, no, we want to see Atheist Republic. And YouTube is like, no, we don't think you want this. We're like, no, please show it to us. We say to you, we want to see Atheist Republic. And YouTube is like, no, we think we know what's better for you than you yourself. So to solve that, there's a link in the description, which is to our newsletter. So hopefully we could email it to you. So hopefully you get some of our content that way. Okay. So yeah. Subscribe to our newsletter as well. And share our videos, because, you know, we do get demonetized. That's an obvious on every one of our videos. So F that, but we don't care about that anymore. But we also get deprioritized, and that's even more damaging to us. Deprioritized. What does that mean? That means we don't show up on the suggested, you know, videos on the right and all that, you know, on people's homepages. And that's how channels grow. Unfortunately, we can't grow. So we need you guys to share our videos. So-